My name is Blessy George. I work in Dr. Lauren Aleksunes' lab at Rutgers University in the Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology. I am from New Jersey originally. I've been at Rutgers for the past 7 years. My dad is a science teacher in Newark, but he has a PhD from India in chemistry. So my mom works in the court right now, but she used to work in a bank in India. They both immigrated here 10 years ago. Definitely they emphasize being in the science major a lot because it's a lot of career stability as well as like pride given to science in India and science, math. Basically the STEM field is very emphasized in Indian culture. So we are looking at the side effects of a chemotherapy known as cisplatin, and it's highly effective. And the problem with that is there's a dose-related kidney injury that happens in about 1/3 of the patients. And the current biomarkers that are used in the hospitals to monitor, they are not as sensitive as we would like it to be. So we are investigating new biomarkers that can detect kidney injury earlier. So the way we analyze our data is we have urine collected from patients that are undergoing this chemotherapy, and so to detect if they have this biomarker of interest, we use a magnetic bead that binds to the specific protein that we're looking for. There's also a reporter fluorescent dye that binds, and when lasers beam at it, it reports and generates results for us. I am also looking at how therapy can be changed, so if a physician is able to choose one agent versus another and how to minimize the side effect on kidney, that would be my long-lasting goal if I can impact how a medicine is picked. And we also discuss as a group at lab meetings, you know, what is the best way to fix this problem, and you know, everybody gives ideas and we put it together. But individually, we work on our different projects. I've had a lot of friends and family go through this. My aunt was diagnosed with breast cancer as well. So I've had people in the family. I know so many people that are affected by cancer. Like really nowadays, who isn't affected is the question, yeah. In high school, my favorite subjects were chemistry, biology, so I knew I was going into a science field. Given that my dad is a chemistry teacher, he also does experiments at home, or he will show me what to do with acid-base, basic stuff, but I really enjoyed doing that. And I went to an engineering type of high school, so there was not a lot of females in our class. I was 1 out of 10 females in our class. Yeah, so I really liked that as a female, I was going into a STEM field. So I actually have a doctor of pharmacy degree from Rutgers University. And as I was taking pharmacology classes, I also became interested in learning about the side effects of medications. So that is what our graduate program in toxicology studies. I wouldn't say that I'm good at math, but I take a long time, more than usual other individuals, I would say. But with practice, I've gotten better and better. Especially in my field of pharmacy, you need to be more accurate than fast, so it's better to take your time and get the right result.
Wakes you up in the morning and makes you excited to come to work?
Definitely being able to see a certain result for the first time. Nobody else has seen this result or has done this experiment before. That really keeps me going. I'm the first person to see this, I could have gone to be a pharmacist, but I'm going into research because this area interests me more than other areas. So I'm going for my PhD, so to attain the PhD in toxicology. That is my short-term goal. So with that degree, I can go into a lot of different fields, industry, pharmaceutical industry that is, or I could go into teaching, or I could go to a hospital and work on clinical research. So everybody thinks that, I don't need to go into research. There's other people, there are smarter people that are doing this work, but really that's not true. And you may have unique skills that another person does not. And that may contribute to a huge, unique finding that only you as a person can do. So it's not really good to leave it to another person. And there's a call on each person to ask questions that are relevant to you.